He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Okay, so for this practice problem, we're going to look at this molecule and we want to label the primary, secondary, tertiary, and quaternary carbons. This is going to be very important to be able to do because in certain reactions, we might want to make a differentiation between what, say, a secondary carbon would do versus a tertiary or something like that. So we definitely need to be able to identify which carbons on a molecule are primary, secondary, tertiary, or quaternary. So I have this key right here. You can use whatever you want, but I'm going to show you a red circle on the primary carbons, a green box on the secondary, a blue triangle on the tertiary, and an asterisk for any quaternary carbon. So go ahead and see if you can label all these carbons on this molecule. Okay, so I've gone ahead and labeled the carbons according to the scheme that I selected here. Now remember, when we're identifying the substitution of these carbons, it only matters how many carbon atoms that a carbon is connected to. So looking first at the primary carbons, any carbon that is connected to just one other carbon is a primary carbon. So going from left to right, this carbon is primary because it is connected to one other carbon. It does not matter that there is a hydroxyl group because only carbons count in terms of the way we're labeling these, because this ends up being a primary alcohol. Because it's a primary carbon, it's a primary alcohol. So this is a primary carbon. There's the other carbon. These two are only connected to that. This is connected to just that. This is connected to just that. And these two are connected to just that. So those are the primary carbons. Now the secondary carbons, we've just got these three. Now right here, it doesn't matter that this is connected to chlorine. This ends up being a secondary haloalkane in that regard for the chlorine, because this is a secondary carbon connected to two carbons. This is connected to these two, and this is connected to these two. So those are the three secondary carbons we have on this molecule. Then the tertiary carbons are going to be connected to three other carbons. So this guy is connected to 1, 2, 3. This guy is connected to 1, 2, 3. This guy is connected to 1, 2, 3. So those are the three tertiary carbons on the molecule. And then as it happens, there's only one quaternary carbon. A quaternary carbon is connected to four other carbons, and that's 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is very important to be able to do because when we look at a reaction, we need to be able to say, this is a tertiary haloalkane, or this is a secondary alcohol, because that is gonna give us some information about what it's gonna be able to do in a reaction. So ideally, we were able to label this just this way. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.